All right, let's play with some of these substitutions in practice. All right, here we are back in that simple text file, the play HTML file I was playing with before. And we're gonna use this because it's a little bit quicker to demonstrate what I'd like to talk about. So I'm gonna enter some text. So I've typed in some text, I save this, and I load this in my browser. Okay, so here we are, I've loaded this text in my browser, and if you remember, if I just type in plain text in an HTML file, it just shows up as plain text in the browser. Okay, now, I'm gonna surround this tag with angle brackets. And let's see how this renders in our browser. When I reload my browser, that word HTML disappeared. That's because when I put angle brackets around it, it turned into a tag. And tags don't render in HTML, they turn into tags. So if we use the escaping we just learned, and I replace this less than symbol with our escape, which is ampersand LT semicolon, and I replace the greater than with ampersand greater than semicolon, and I reload this in my browser, what we see is the actual text that we wanted to demonstrate, which is the actual angle brackets. So let's try another quick example of this. If I were to change the string HTML to the word B, or to the letter B, and save this and reload in my browser, we now have the B tag. And if I were to go back to my editor and change these less thans and greater thans back into the actual less than and greater than, and reload this in my browser, our text turns to bold. So if we don't want our HTML to behave as HTML, we need to escape it. And if we want it to behave as HTML, we don't escape it. All right, try some escaping on your own. So what is the correct way to include the text ampersand equals ampersand AMP semicolon in rendered HTML? So it should look like this once it's rendered in the browser. What do we need to include in the HTML to get that output?